How are you today? Time to talk housewives. So I got two really good housewives stories for you today. First, we're going to talk about Teddy Mendelkamp, the ex-alum from The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills, getting her own reality TV. Her own reality TV show. Now, don't forget, she got canned, okay, in so many words, for being boring, but now she wants her own reality TV show. And then we're going to talk about the looks that the lady have been released for the Real Housewives of New Jersey reunion. But okay, guys, let's get into this Teddy Mendelkamp thing. Okay, so we all know that Teddy was fired for basically being boring. No one liked Teddy except for Kyle, okay? It is what it is. Not to be mean to Teddy. I'm sure you're nice deep down on the inside, but you don't make good television. You bored the hell out of people. And not only did you bore the hell out of people, you did it for 3 or 4 years. It was a long, painful road of having Teddy Mendelkamp on The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. So, you know, people weren't really sad to see her go. That's not being mean. It's just facts, okay, people? It's just facts. And that's what I do on this channel. I tell the facts and the truth. No one was really sad to see her go. But her, she was the only person sad. Her and Kyle, I don't work anymore. You know, I wish they would have told me. Remember that whole spiel that she gave and, oh, I'm going to miss the ladies. No one's going to miss you. You were terrible television. And I thought, good. Adios. Sayonara. See you later. Never to be seen again. That's what I was hoping. No such luck. She came out yesterday and announced that she will be having her own reality TV show. Now, who in the hell's going to watch that reality TV show? Teddy is boring. I don't care if it's her and her family, her and her workplace. I don't care where she is, what setting, who she's around. Snooze fest. Okay, people, she's boring. There, I said it. But to make matters even worse, you're thinking, what's worse than Teddy getting her own reality TV show? Well, I'll tell you what's worse than that. What the reality TV show is going to be about. It's going to be about her exercise program called All In, where she gives you dieting tips and exercise tips and, you know, for you to get healthy and fit and live your best life. Well, why would you make a TV show around that? This was the most controversial subject. I don't even think they brought it up on the show. Of Teddy's career, okay? Because people are accusing that program of being a starvation program. I'm not making this up, people. I'm not making it up. You're only allowed to eat 500 calories a day. That's a half a piece of a chicken, probably about this size. And then when you're not eating that, you know, this half a piece of chicken, you're working out all day long. People accuse her of starvation. Makes this make sense to me, people? You're boring the hell out of us, and then you want to remind us how people consider your program a starvation program? I couldn't make this up if you paid me to. What? Look, I don't see how this is going to be a hit in any kind of way. Any kind of way. Teddy Mendelkamp, the bore queen, is having her own reality TV show essentially about starving. I don't understand it. Make it make sense, people. Make it make sense. I mean, whose bright idea was this? You know whose idea it probably was? Kyle. It was either Kyle's saying, you could do it, Teddy. Stop lying to her. No, she cannot. Go get your own reality TV show. The public will love it. No, we won't. No one wants to see any you exercising people until their deathbeds. No one wants to see that. I mean, it just doesn't make sense. I'm not going to shade Teddy for trying. Oh, I guess I just did now, didn't I? It just doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense. You are putting a spotlight on the biggest controversy of your career is that people consider it a starvation plan. And you want us to look at it while we watch you, you know, jog up and down the street and then take naps. Because you are so boring. I mean, I don't know if I'm being, is that bad? Am I being mean to Teddy? I just don't see who's going to watch this show. But okay, you know, I guess I'll give it a try. I mean, I guess, right? Anyway, someone thought it was a good idea. Maybe it was Teddy who thought, well, if Kyle can go and produce a show and get her own show, so can I. No, you cannot. I don't know who's lying to Teddy or if she's lying to herself, but somebody better tell her the truth. I mean, this is a bad idea, but okay, it is what it is. I don't know who gave you the green light or why, but I guess we'll soon find out. Let's move on. So now let's move on to the Real Housewives of New Jersey. So they released the reunion looks for the women, and I have to say, they're all beautiful women. There really isn't much bad to say about them. If I had to say who was best dressed, it's a toss-up to me between Teresa and Jennifer Aiden. Jennifer Aiden absolutely looks stunning to me. Very, very stunning. I love Teresa's dress, so I'm going to give them both. I'm going to give Jennifer Aiden an A. I think she's best dressed. She is stunningly beautiful. And then I'm going to give Teresa a minus. I just love the slit in the dress. And, you know, you're being a little sexy, but then you're being modest by having full sleeves. I think both of these women look amazing. I mean, but Dolores doesn't look bad either. I mean, if this dress would have been any darker, if it would have been a darker shade or gold, she would have looked like an Oscar. So she stopped at the right shade of gold. But, you know, it's okay. I don't have anything bad to say about it. I don't have anything too raving to say about it. I think her body looks amazing. I'm just going to give her a C. She looks nice and presentable and ready to go. I mean, it is what it is. I've seen her look better before, but her body looks good, so that's good. And she's just a pretty woman, too. I really, really like Dolores. Melissa also looks good. She looks like a beautiful prostitute in the making. I mean, this dress is really risque and almost reminds me of like a nightgown or some kind of negligee, but it looks good on her. If you have the body to wear it, wear it. So I'm going to go ahead and give her a C too. I mean, Joe's probably having a fit, Gorga, because you know, he doesn't like her showing too much, but you know, she has been saying the last couple of episodes to hell with Joe. So she looks good. And I really got to give her a C+. For the cause of giving Joe high blood pressure. Then there's Margaret showing her boobs again. I mean, she paid for them and she's gonna make sure that she makes it worth her money to show those things off anytime that she can. And so the reunion is no exception. She looks amazing though. And what I really like most about Margaret is her hair. I like her hair and I think her facelift is amazing. It really makes her look beautiful, in my opinion, if you ask me. I mean, I didn't know a simple facelift could make someone look so beautiful. You know, because usually when you get a facelift, it's like you're taking a chance. It could mess up or it could come out good. And she came out extremely good. So I'm going to go ahead and give Margaret maybe a B. I think Margaret looks great for her age. Now let's talk Jackie. I would say this is the only dress that I have any complaints about. This look does not do it for me at all. The top half reminds me of something out of the Roman Empire. I mean, it just swings to the side and then it looked like you wanted a mini skirt and then that long tassel thing hanging from it. It just doesn't work for me. And that's not to be mean. I'm just saying my opinion. She is absolutely the worst dress. But even worse than her clothes would be... should I dare say it? She just looks a little too thin for me. Like, she hasn't eaten in weeks. I don't know if there's a such thing as being too thin, and I know she has an eating disorder that gets triggered very easily. She just came off of a very stressful season with Teresa accusing her man of cheating. I don't know what's going on, but her legs, they really look like toothpicks. I just would feel more comfortable if she had a sandwich. Just a couple more pounds. You don't have to be overweight, but you're getting borderline to me, in my opinion. Therefore, I'm going to have to give Jackie a D plus because I like her. A D plus, this is not, the look is looking bad and you look bad in the dress. Is that bad? So there you have it, people. Those are my two stories for the day. Now we have a lot to talk about in the comments section. Is anybody, and I mean anybody, planning on watching Teddy Mellencamp's reality TV show? If you're all in, let me know. If you're all out, let me know that too. And I gave you my thoughts on the ladies' new look for the reunion on my grading system, A through F. Let me know your thoughts about it in the comments section. Am I being too hard on Jackie, who I vote worst dressed? Also, if you like this video, don't forget to click that like button. It does wonders for my video. If you haven't already subscribed and hit the notification bell, don't forget to do that. I'll see you guys down in the comment section. We have a lot to talk about. Until next time, bye for now.